Hey, it's Coach Nick Tumminello. I have the pleasure of coming to you with my very good friend, Lee Taft, the speed guru. And Lee's been nice enough to dedicate a few minutes of time to educate us on some speed concepts, right?
You got it.
Take it away, Lee.
Let's talk quickly about acceleration. We're talking about two things. We're talking about straight ahead acceleration. There's a technique that I actually endorse. I didn't develop it. It's something that I endorse, and I call it a plyo step. You'll hear it different names, but it's a plyo step. And what we're going to do is we're going to look at an athlete who's in an athletic stance in a reactive situation, which is sport. Sport is reactive and random. And what's going to happen is that athlete is going to see a ball drop in front of them by their coach dropping the ball, and they're going to react and go get it. Here's how they do it. They're here, they'll see it. You'll see the foot drive back, which pushes them into acceleration. That's called the plyo step. The second one is let's go backwards now. Retreating is an important skill in sports. So now what we're going to do is we're going to have to open our body up and move backwards. But we don't want to use a pivot because pivoting is too slow, and if you have cleats on, it's quite dangerous. So we're going to use what's called a hip turn. We drive, the hips come around, we push away. So the plyo step, right, and the hip turn are basically the same concept, and it's just an innate ability of the body to reposition the feet to drive through acceleration. So there's a couple of tips for you, and hopefully that helps.
Sounds good. That's awesome stuff. And now, what do you see, just so they know, what are some of the traditional things that you see in speed that maybe would go against that? Like, for instance, you see a lot of coaches doing a lean fall start, and that's kind of a very, very slow start. Is that a technique that you use, or you just have people just do this wide?
Yeah, well, because if we're working at pure linear speed and we're a track athlete, the falling start or the lean start has application because what you're working on there is the leg that initially is going to start driving down or back. But for random sport, it doesn't apply as much because it's about reacting to the situation at hand. So that would be one that I wouldn't use. And then when we start talking about reversing our body, opening up, pivoting creates friction. Plus, like I said, if the cleats are dug into the turf, we got to be careful of the injury. So those are things that I traditionally try to stay away from. And athletes naturally move the way that I was just talking about, and that's why I endorse them.
Is there some sort of training progression or regression for, let's focus on just the linear plyo step?
There can be. There doesn't have to be because it's such a natural skill. But if we're going to do it, we're going to start working on the distance at which the athlete has to go get the ball or go chase them. That's the progression because the further out I go, the more aggressive and the more demanding it's going to be. That's where if you were just standing 5 feet behind me, now my movement is going to be very subtle and very basic. I can start adding bands to resist you. Now the loading phase of that acceleration move gets higher. So that would be an improvement on the progression of it.
Fantastic. There you have it. You got some great tips from one of the speed gurus or the best in the business.
Thanks.
Where can they find more information about you?
Well, if you just go to sportspeed.com, you can find more, or even the Lee Taft Speed Academy.com, you can find me that way.